Vandy, a dynamic leader with decades of experience building companies and crushing sales. He's been there and done that.
Ladies and gentlemen, hello. My name is Vandy.
Inspiring audiences across the country to do it too. Here's Van.
Well, hello, everybody, and welcome to the Van Deeb Podcast. I'm glad you're here. I'm really, really excited today because I've got somebody very special with me today, and her name is Jeana Goosmann with the Goosmann Law Firm. And she is not just in that industry, but she is doing things that I think is going to become the blueprint someday of what people would like to do in running their business. So we're going to do a three-part series on our podcast, and the first part one is going to be about culture. I'm super impressed with the way Jeana has her company and the way she's created culture, and I want her to share that with my audience. And then the second part is going to be about service and how you not only want to serve your clients, but you also want to serve the people that work within your firm. And once again, when I walk in her firm, you can just tell that the people are extremely happy. And then part three is going to be about engaging in the community. And Jeana is going to get a chance to tell us on that part all about one of her conferences that she just recently had, called the Be Worth It Conference. And I'm just really excited to introduce her. And she's just coming off launching her book, and it made it to the bestseller list. And all, there's just so many things to talk about. But first of all, I want to say welcome, Jeana.
Thanks, Van. I'm really excited to be here with you today.
Thank you. Jeana, before we get started, just so my audience knows a little bit about you, you are from Omaha.
I am from Omaha. I'm a Burke Bulldog. I went to high school. Yes, just like Van.
Yay, we're both Burke Bulldogs. Yay. Only I went there about 30 years before you. So
we don't need to mention that part,
no,
Van.
So
originally from Omaha, I went to college at the University of Nebraska in Lincoln, so I'm also a Husker. I was a business major while at Nebraska and really involved in the entrepreneurship program, and that's what drove me to go to law school.
Wow, that's awesome. Yeah, so we're all big fans of University of Nebraska here in these parts. So your law firm, you're not only in Omaha, you're also in Sioux Falls?
Yes. So we're in Omaha, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, and Sioux City, Iowa. After graduating from Creighton, I moved back to Sioux City, Iowa, where my husband had business.
Okay, great. Well, we're glad you're doing it here. And I tell you, it's pretty recognizable, the name Goosmann Law, because you see it everywhere in their they're really growing, and just a company that I really admire. So I'm going to get right into it, Jeana, if that's all right with you, and talk about culture. So I'm a big fan of culture, and people that listen to my podcast and read my books or my newsletters know that I'm a big fan of Southwest Airlines because of the way that they built their culture and the way that their employees and they just always seem so happy. And you got to give it to just the way that they built that company. So I always use them as a benchmark. But, you know, when I walked into your office this last year, I could just tell that just the way that the people were that were in the firm, that they really enjoy this culture. It seemed like I saw a lot of smiling faces. I don't know how many smiling faces you see in a law firm, but there sure seemed to be like there was a lot of them. So what are you doing to create that kind of culture at Goosmann Law?
Well, I'm really excited that you noticed the culture, because culture is one of our key values, Van. And I have a concept that I call the culture jury that I've developed and I speak a lot about within my book, Worth It. And the culture jury concept came out of when I lead a jury trial, I often do a mock trial with a jury consultant before the actual trial itself. And through that process, we've gotten to know and talk with people and get into their head and see exactly why they view things the way that they do. And what I've realized is it's really the leader that sets the tone for the culture within the organization. And the leader, just like a lead trial attorney, is on stage and being judged by your employees or your team. And they're the ones that set the tone and set the culture for your environment.
Wow. So, you know, that's just like the saying then, you know, when you talk about leadership, and I do a considerable amount of consulting, and, you know, you can tell when a company, you can tell when it's not doing well, and they're asking you to kind of find out why, and you spend some time with the leader and you see why. You know, they say, isn't it true that they say people don't quit their company, they quit their manager, the person in charge? And I think that's so true, that leadership is so important. And I can tell that you really, that's very important to you, is to making sure that you're given great leadership.
As the leader, you have to show up and be the leader that others want to follow every day. And in every circumstance and situation, just like a jury's watching you when you're in court, your employees are watching you and how you lead the company.
So leadership isn't like, well, I'm going to be a great leader Monday through Thursday and not be on Friday. It's a 24-hour position.
And you're giving them evidence, whether it be your social media feed or the way you present in a particular meeting or how you handle a really tough circumstance. All those different situations are feeding them how you lead, and then that sets the tone and the culture for your environment.
Yeah, see, that's very impressed when I come into your office. So tell me, Jeana, this book that you just wrote, and I'm super excited about it because I got a chance to read it. And if you can tell the audience, you have a significant meaning for the word red. Tell me what that means.
I do. The book is called Worth It. And in the book, it's for business leaders, and I focus on how to be successful in business and in life using my RED model, which RED stands for Ready, Execute, Deliver.
So, you know, if you think about it, that business model right there, Ready, Execute, and Deliver, that's everybody's business. That's
it is.
Everything. I mean, we all need to incorporate that because so many people procrastinate. You know, they plan, but they don't execute or they don't deliver. So I really enjoyed your book. And I think anybody out there that is interested in upping their game and increasing their market share and just learning from a different source should get your book. Can you tell my audience where they can get the book at?
Amazon. Worth It, Jeana Goosmann. You'll be able to find it right there on Amazon.
Now, I've heard of Amazon. Is that a big company?
Just a little one. Yeah. You know, they might show up at my house every day.
I tell you what, I think it's crazy. You know, I've been ordering stuff online for quite a while now, and it's too easy. But it'll be easy for them to order your book and get it delivered right away.
There really is momentum between those three things, isn't there, Van? Where you, if you get ready and you do the front work, you do have to pull the trigger and execute. And how you go about executing, there's a lot of different techniques and tips there too. Mm-hmm. But ultimately, it's upon the leader to deliver. And you still have that weight on your shoulders when you're leading a business because you have to make it happen.
Yeah. And people look to the leaders not only for to guide them, but direction. And, you know, most people that want to exceed in a company want to emulate their leader. They want to be like the person that's in charge. And I think the way that you do that with Goosmann Law is very impressive. I just get excited when I come into your office and see everybody working so hard and people are so happy.
It does take a team, though. We talk a lot about leadership and also cultivating other leaders within the team.
So tell me something about, so you're right now, you're in Omaha, Sioux Falls, and Sioux City?
Yes.
So you're in three locations. Are you planning on growing? Is there any other areas of the Midwest that you'd like to see yourself in?
Right now, we're really focused on our three markets, but our long-term vision is to dominate the Midwest.
Dominate the Midwest. I like that. Well, you're a household name in the Midwest, so that shouldn't be very hard. And you know, Omaha, Nebraska, we're growing at 1% a year. That doesn't sound like a lot, but that's 10,000 people a year in a 5-county market. And, you know, that's a lot of people coming into Omaha. And I think people like you, Jeana, that are getting established and getting set up, I think that you're going to see the growth in this city just take off. And, you know, being in the real estate business, and that's my background, is all the corrections that I've been involved with the last 35 years, Omaha just seems to be a flat line when it comes to that. We don't have the downs. But then again, we don't have the ups. It's not like we have one extreme to the other. So we stay pretty balanced here.
We've been one of the fastest growing law firms in the country in 2017 and 2018, and I'm pretty sure we're a contender again this year. Jeez. I credit a lot of that to our Omaha office and the growth that we've had here in Omaha. We have a solid team here. About half of our team is now located in Omaha.
My gosh. So you've got attorneys that specialize in every area.
Really focused on business leaders. Okay. And full service to what that business leader needs. We help business leaders win disputes, protect their wealth, and do deals so they can spend their time on what's worth it.
So you're building relationships. That was good. I mean, that's exactly what a business leader wants. So you're building relationships with people regardless of, even if they don't need your services right now, you're building relationships with them. So when they do, they've got a comfort zone with you.
Everything's about relationships and building trust, Van, as yeah. you know, and you're the king of that.
Well, I feel very blessed. I think that the Midwest has got some really, really great people, and what a great place to do business in. But once again, Jeana, so we're talking about culture today, and you see more and more companies that are making that a priority. I know. When I ran my real estate firm, and I had 350 plus agents before I sold it, my competitors wanted to know, why don't you have the turnover that the industry has, that the real estate industry has? People don't seem to quit. And my response always was, is I wanted to make those people feel like they were valuable, because they were. You know, they're the ones that keep the lights on. So it wasn't unusual for me to walk by somebody's office and say, thank you for being here today. Because if it wasn't for them, the company wouldn't be there. And that was kind of my attitude, is you make them feel important, make them feel special, make them feel like they matter. They're the ones that are creating that culture. Isn't that what your blueprint is similar?
It's very similar, Van, and I think there's another fundamental layer in that. And what I studied with law firms in particular is that usually they're set up like silos. So they reward, their structure does, individuals for individual behaviors. Goosmann Law Firm is set up more like a traditional business where our leaders are responsible for a team, and you win as a team, and therefore you're rewarded as a team. And when you have a team-based structure, it really delivers more of that team-based approach as well for a client. So if there's an attorney that maybe focuses on real estate and that client has an employment issue, they're incentivized to make sure that we have the right person serving that client, because we win as a team rather than individual silos at the Goosmann Law Firm.
Wow. Jeana, was there one person that was influential to you that you tried to build your company from, that just by seeing somebody else or somebody you admire or another company that you really admire?
There have been many, many people, Van. And one of the things I learned, I remember I had a fourth grade science teacher say this, and it was the one thing I took away. And he said, find traits you admire in other people and try and place them in yourself. So there are lots of things that I admire in others, and then I just have tried to emulate and adopt those. And that applies as well in the company and in the business. So whether it be that we use Gallup Strength Finder within the company, or we also use Traction from Gino Wickman. So I pull in, there's not just one particular place, but I wouldn't claim that anything I do is original. It's just best practice adopted from many.
Well, it's like in my business of going out and getting people motivated and inspired and empower them to be better at what they do. You know, it's stuff that we've been talking about for 100 years. So there's really, what you're doing is you're doing what other people are doing and perfecting it. I know, you know, I keep bringing up Southwest Airlines, but when I built my real estate firm, I really paid attention to what Southwest did. You know, when you're talking to employees and they're telling you constantly how happy they are, I want to know why. What are they doing to make you come out and say, we're really happy at this firm? So my philosophy was, a matter of fact, our motto was a company built by agents for agents. We figured that if we concentrate on making our people happy, what are they going to do when they're out with their customers? You know, they're going to be doing the same thing, hopefully even more. But I looked at my staff and my employees and people I worked with as my customers. And I feel like that's kind of the way you do it with your staff and with your attorneys. I've gotten a chance to get to know several of them, and they really have nothing but incredibly great things to say about working at Goosmann Law.
It's taking those great business principles, just like you did with the airline industry, and applying them to real estate is what we're trying to do within the law firm. I think that when you have those happy team members, they do help reinforce your clients' expectations and deliver that service. Mm-hmm. Our mission at the firm is worth it. It's two words. It's really simple. And then that has transcended into the name of my book. But really, it's how do you make it worth it for those team members to be on your team, as well as how do you make it worth it for your customers or your clients to do business with your organization? It's all about delivering value and perceived value as well. Like, people have to feel that value when they show up and be on your team or when they do business with you.
So those two words, worth it, that's kind of like your motto. That's what makes your company run, is you use that in everything, not just for the people that work at your firm, but for your clients. That's the important phrase there, is worth it.
It is. It's really how we make all of our decisions. And once you start to listen for it in everyday conversation too, you'll see that people, that's what it boils down to. Yeah. Am I going to hire this next employee? Is it worth it? Okay. Am I going to do business with this company over here? Do I feel the value? Is it worth it? Yeah. How you decide really boils down to whether or not you perceive the value.
Yeah, see, I really, really like that. And, you know, you can use that in so many different circumstances throughout your business day. And so when I talk about culture, we're going to wrap this part, this segment up here in just a little bit. When I talk about culture, you're not only watching other companies of what they're doing right, but you're paying attention to what they're doing wrong. You're paying attention to what you might have done wrong in the past. And I've learned more, Jeana, from other people's failures. And I've learned more from my own failures, to build on that. And that has helped me know what I don't want to do and go strong in the opposite direction. Do you feel like you've, in growing your business, that you've seen things that maybe you started out doing that you changed?
Absolutely. I have a great example in that, Van. And when I opened the office in Fargo, I didn't go all in. I went small. I had one person in a rented office space. And within 9 months, that office just didn't survive. There was some need up there, but I personally wasn't vested. I didn't have the self-sacrifice, and I didn't commit the firm to its fullest potential. I learned from that and compare it to when we opened in Omaha. I hired a big-time managing partner, and now we have a team of 25 within 2 years in a Class A space. We went all in. Everything was on the line, and I'm personally committed. I'm in the Omaha office every week, multiple times a week, and I'm part of this community as well. And I think that's really what the differentiator is. If you commit yourself and you go all in, everybody can tell. And when you commit at that level and you have that personal self-sacrifice, you're bound to be successful.
Boy, I tell you what, I could bottle up what you just said, because that's, you know, I hope there's a lot of people in your industry listening, because I think they could learn a lot from your attitude and the way that you do business and your belief system. Really love the worth it campaign. And that's not something that's going to go away. That's going to be with you forever.
It's going to be with me forever. And I think you'll find that it's within business leaders too. We have to drive value today. And that's ultimately what leaders are deciding, whether or not they're going to do business with other individuals or other companies. It boils down to whether or not they find the worth.
I really liked it. And you know, you had said you have a Class A space. I've been to your office several times, and just a warm, inviting place to be. But one of the things I really like is there's plenty of parking. I don't have to worry about trying to find a place to park. It's a big building. It's a great part of Omaha. It's 180th and Dodge area. For those of you that have not seen the big sign on the building, says Goosmann Law. But so, Jeana, that's going to wrap up part one of talking about culture. And I'm so excited that we've got two more parts that people will be able to listen to. But as of today, Jeana, thank you for being with us and on the Van Deeb podcast and talking about culture. And ladies and gentlemen, this has been Jeana Goosmann talking about culture with me, Van Deeb. And I'm looking forward, Jeana, to the next two episodes.
Thank you, Van. Me too.
Yep. So anyway, thank you. And don't forget to rate, review, and subscribe to the Van Deeb podcast.
A Parkville Media Production.